Okay, so welcome to lab number 5, and this lab number 5 for linear control system is to observe the step response of a second order system. And last week we discussed first order systems. So as we know that the order of the system can be defined by simply the highest value of power in the denominator. So s plus 2, yeah, or s plus 10 divided by s plus 2, the s was having the highest value of the power of 1, so it was considered as a first order system. So if there is equation like s square plus s plus 2, 10 s square plus s plus 2, so now this one is a second order system. So second order systems are commonly encountered in practice and are simplest type of dynamic system to exhibit oscillations. So this system will have some oscillations, and these systems will be you will find most of this system practically around you, like RLC circuits and like mass spring and damper systems. In fact, many higher order systems are modeled as second order system to facilitate the analysis. Means ke jo hamare paas system hote hain higher order ke, third order, fourth order, we reduce them to systems of like a second order system. And then later what we do is basically we apply some mathematical or some control system on them, and then these systems are these systems are checked, and then we can again use them in our daily life. Okay, so what are the types of second order systems? We have different types, like we have underdamped second order systems, overdamp, critically damp, and undamp. So the underdamp systems, we have some oscillations. Okay, for overdamp systems we have no oscillations, and for critically damp system again we have no oscillations, but their response is quicker than those of the overdamp systems. Then we have undamp system. The undamped system, basically these are oscillating, always oscillating. Okay, so these are different types of systems, and we will be discussing one by one. Every each system we will discuss one by one. Okay, so first of all we have a underdamped system. ठीक है जलाल, आई होप आपको आवाज़ आ रही है जी, क्लियर है स्क्रीन वगैरह भी, क्लियर है? आप ज़रा टाइप करके या माइक खोल के भी आप मुझे बता सकते हैं. मैं यहाँ पे देखता भी हूँ कि अगर किसी और ने फ़िलहाल तो ज्वाइन नहीं किया. ओके, सो okay, good Jalal, thank you. So the underdamped systems, basically the zeta here, which is the damping ratio, is less than 1, and then the poles, they have two poles which are complex and have negative real parts. The system is stable and it has some oscillations while approaching to its steady state value. Okay, so now if you can see, I will just zoom into this screen so that you can see here. As I told you that the system will have two poles. So this is the pole zero map. One pole is on 10 and other pole is on minus 10 on the y-axis. And then if we see the x-axis, which is the real axis, both the poles are on minus 2. So two poles having negative real parts, which means minus 2, and imaginary portions like 10 and minus 10. These are different imaginary parts. And then, as I told you, that there will be some oscillation. So if you see the system, it will oscillate and then it will be it will achieve its steady state. So the second order system, this is a underdamped response, system. Okay, so let's come towards the code, how we will simulate it in MATLAB. So in the MATLAB, first of all, we will define the gain of the system, which is KDC. Okay, then we will define the natural frequency of the system, like natural frequency, like if the system is going to be is going to have no damping ratio, and the system will oscillate for a period of time, so the oscillation of the system will have the frequency of 10. Next we have zeta. Zeta is the damping ratio. Basically, zeta defines the type of second order system. If it is less than 1, like the one here, 0.2, then it is a underdamped system. If it is 1, then it is a critically damped system. Okay, if it is more than 1, then it is a overdamped system. And if it is 0, it means that it is a undamped system. So for first example, we have taken zeta as 0.2. Then we have another line of code which says S is equal to TFS. So now you know that we have to define the symbolic variables, or we have to apply the function of TF on S. Now what will happen, that after we define or after we execute this line, the every variable which has S in its denominator will be considered as a transfer function. Okay, so for defining transfer functions, we need to apply TF function of TF on S. Okay, then this is the characteristic equation of our second order systems. Okay, so the value of KDC, the value of natural frequency WN, the value of zeta are all required, because we have to put these values in the characteristic equation of our second order system. So the equation is KDC multiplied by natural frequency raised to the power 2. Okay, so this one, this sign here is for raised to the power. Then we have S square, and divided, this whole value is divided by S square plus 2 zeta into natural frequency S into S and natural frequency square. So this is the characteristic equation, and you will find this equation in your Norman Nye's book, and you will also find this equation, the derivation of this equation on the in your chapters in the Norman Nye's book, which you will study in the theoretical class. Then we have figure, step G1. The figure command is used to plot multiple figures or multiple graphs. And then step is basically a command to plot the step response, which you can see on right side bottom, right bottom of your screen. This is a command to actually simulate or plot a step response. Okay, then there is a pole zero map. Okay, pole zero map G1. Okay, pole zero map G1 is basically a function to plot the poles and zeros of your system. and which is g1. We have saved our equation in g1. Next, there is an axis command. First of all, we will run our system without this axis command, and then I will add this axis command to your MATLAB code, and then you will see that what is actually the advantage or use of this axis command. Okay. So we will go towards MATLAB. I have to run MATLAB right now, and on the MATLAB we will be we will simulate this system. Okay, ji, Usama has also joined. Welcome, Usama. I hope everyone will join. More people will join. Okay, so I'm just waiting for MATLAB to open. It's okay, Osama, you can join any of the two sections. So course is same, we are on the same track, so you can join it. Okay, so right now I'm waiting for MATLAB to be open, and also I think okay, screen sharing. Let's see that it allows MATLAB to be open. Yes, here we have MATLAB. Okay, so in the MATLAB, I'm going to open a new script file, and then I'm going to write my code on this script file. Okay, so I'm just waiting for MATLAB to settle down. I don't see it on your screen, so once it's on your screen, so we will be we'll start working on that. Acha, mere khayal se Jalal baki class join nahi kar rahi. Which shayad issue hoga. So there is no one on Skype as well. Okay, so MATLAB is open here. And I have written my code in MATLAB. Simple data file. Okay. So I've written my code over here, the same code which I showed you in the PowerPoint slides, and this code we will execute it now, and we will see that what is the response. Okay, so I have executed the code. So now you can see this is the step response, and this is showing you the output of your system. So now we have to, in the step response, we have to see multiple parameters of our system. So just right click on the response, okay, on the window, and now on the characteristic, I will repeat it, just right click, and on the characteristic you will see peak response, settling time, rise time, and steady state. So these are different values of your response. So we will start with peak response. Okay, so when you click on peak response, you will see that now there is a point which is the highest point your waveform has achieved, and this highest point is actually the overshoot. This shows the overshoot of your system. So now you can see that 52.7% is the overshoot of your system. What is happening here is the desired response was 1. Okay, we want our system to get steady on 1, to achieve the steady state value of 1, but our system has overshooted up to 1.5. so it means that we are having around 52 to 53% of overshoot. के मतलब ये जो अपनी value है, जो value इसने achieve करनी थी, उससे 53% या 52% जो है, वो आगे चला गया. ठीक है? So this is the overshoot. Okay. Next we click on settling time. Okay. Now you see there is a dot here. Settling time is 1.96 seconds. Now, what is actually a settling time? Settling time is the amount of time your response takes to, you can say that to oscillate between plus 1 and minus 1. Like oscillate between 1% of its final value. Jab ye 1% of the final value, jis tarah agar isne 100 achieve karni hoti, तो 1% होता उसका, मतलब अगर जब ये 99 और 101 के दरमियान ऑसिलेट करना शुरू हो जाता, सो इट मींस के ये आपके पास अभी या इसके यहां तक जो इसने टाइम लिया है, दैट वाज इट्स सेटलिंग टाइम. अच्छा जी, वॉइस क्लियर नहीं है. ओके, सो आई विल अच्छा जी जलाल, अब कुछ क्लियर हुई वॉइस? अच्छा, उसामा कह रहे हैं उनकी क्लियर है जी. अच्छा, ओके, सो डेफिनेटली देयर विल बी सम इश्यू विद योर इंटरनेट जलाल, बट आई विल सेंड दिस रिकॉर्डेड लेक्चर. ओके जलाल, अब क्लियर है वॉइस? Okay. So now the value, we were on the cycling time. So cycling time is the amount of time your response takes to oscillate in 1% of the actual value or the steady state value. Then rise time. Okay. Rise time is actually the time your waveform takes from 1% to 9%. Like your waveform from 1% up to 90% of the final value. So from 0.1, okay, from 0.1 to 0.9 second, so 0.9%, 0.1 to 0.9, it means from 1% to 90%, the time your waveform is going to shoot from 1% to 90% of its steady state value is actually the rise time. Okay, so the rise time here is 0.166. Next we have steady state. So as we know that the final value, the steady state value, is 1 for our system. Okay, so these were four parameters. Number one, we had the peak or the overshoot, then we had the cycling time, then we had the rise time, and then we had the steady state. So Jalal and Usama, I hope ke ye charon parameters aapko clear honge ji. Agar aap log message karke mujhe bata dein. अच्छा जी, तो उसामा कहते हैं, सर कैन वी टेक दिस पैरामीटर्स फॉर अदर वैल्यूज. जी, जो भी आपके सिस्टम होगा, ठीक है, उसका आपको ग्राफ यहाँ पे नज़र आएगा जी, ठीक है, और यही ग्राफ जो होगा आपका, दैट विल बेसिकली हैव मल्टीपल वैल्यूज़, और यही सारी चीज़ें उसमें भी होंगी. तो अभी हम जब बाकी सिस्टम ऑसिलेट, जब बाकी सिस्टम हम देखेंगे, तो किसी में आपका ओवरशूट नहीं होगा, ठीक है, लेकिन राइज टाइम और जो साइकिलिंग टाइम है वो तकरीबन हर जगह होगा, सिर्फ अनडैम के केस में नहीं होगा, लेकिन ओवरशूट जो है सिर्फ अंडर डैम सिस्टम में होगी और उसके बाद नहीं होगी. ठीक है उसामा, ओके, गुड. अच्छा जी, सो नाउ वी कम टू वर्ड्स द पोल जीरो मैप. नाउ यू कैन नॉट सी द पोल्स क्लियरली. अगर आप यहाँ पे लेफ्ट साइड पे देखें तो आपको दो क्रॉस नज़र आ रहे हैं जी, और ये बेसिकली दीज आर द पोल्स. नाउ दिस पोल जीरो मैप इज़ नॉट क्लियर. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू इज वी कैन डिफाइन द एक्सिस, एंड वंस द एक्सिस इज डिफाइंड, सो after the axis is defined, we can go for the we can have a much better view of these pole zeros. So the axis command, let me explain you this axis command. So axis is basically you can say that identify or to select an axis on which you are or to define an axis on which your plot will be printed. Okay, so if you want to define an axis for PZ map, you can write it here. And similarly, if you want to decide identify or define an axis for step response, you can also add a axis command over here. So in this case, our step response was acceptable, but the pole zero map is not clear. So what I have done, I have defined the axis over here. So first of all, we have a round bracket, then we have a square bracket, and in the square bracket I have defined -3 and 1, -3 space 1. Now -3 space 1, what it is doing, it is actually defining the x-axis of your plot. Okay, so -3 and 1 is for the x-axis, and then -15 and +15, these two values are going to define the y-axis of your plot. So I will repeat, first of all write the axis command, then the round brackets are basically whenever you are using a function, you have to write the values inside these round brackets, and then in the square brackets, basically when you are defining an array, when you are defining more than one number, so you have to define them in a inside the square brackets. And then -3 space 1, okay, this is -3 and space 1, so this is your x-axis, and then space -15 and space 15, this is your y-axis. Now I will just copy this command over here and write it in my MATLAB code. So if you have any questions, you can simply type them, or you can open your mic, you can ask me questions. So now I have defined the axis over here. Again, I'm going to run this simulation, this code. Okay, so we have got our transfer function in the MATLAB window. Okay, the command window is the transfer function, and now if you see the pole zero map, now by defining the axis, now we can see a much clearer view of these poles. Okay, just click on them so you can see the values, and you can see the x-axis is from -3 to 1, and the y-axis is from -15 to 15, as we have defined in our MATLAB code. Okay, so now the poles also show you the value is -2 plus 9.8 imaginary portion, and damping of 0.2, which was your zeta, overshoot of 52.7%, which you saw in your step response. Okay, and similarly there, it's also showing the natural frequency, which we have defined it here. Okay, so natural frequency is 10, damping is 0.2. Okay, so this was about the under damp systems. Okay, next we have over damp system. Okay, the over damp system has a zeta of greater than 1. Okay, Usama puch rahe hain, sir, this cross actually represents poles. Yes, Usama, jo cross hai, jo aapke paas cross nazar aa raha tha yahan pe, theek hai? So these are actually your poles. Okay, aur phir agar 0 hoga to phir uske liye 0 bana hoga, lekin there are no zeros so far in our in the second order system. Okay, good. So for over damp systems, the damping ratio will be greater than 1. Both poles will have real and negative values, means ke koi bhi imaginary values mein nahi hogi. Therefore the system is stable and does not oscillate. Okay, so there will be no oscillations. Okay, so this response will be like this. Okay. So this is the code. You can see that here we have KGC again, KGC 1, natural frequency 10, zeta is now 1.2, it was 0.2 in the previous value, in the previous code, which was underdamped system, and it is 1.2 here, and all the other values are same, except that I have stored this transfer function in G2. The first one was stored in G1 and this one I have stored in G2, so therefore I have to change the values for PZ map and step. Also, the axis has to be changed, because when you are changing your damping ratio, the zeta, your axis will, the pole zero will also have different values. Okay, so we will simulate this code again. I will just make some changes in the previous MATLAB code. Okay, so zeta will be now 1.2, and instead of G1, we will save it in G2. And also the value of axis will be changed. So let's simulate it. Okay. So here we can see the step response of our system. If we right click on it and for characteristic, if you click on peak, you will not get any value. So it means that the system has no overshoot at all. The system has directly settled on its settling value or steady state value. Then we click on settling time. So here it is, the here graph shows us settling time, which is actually 0.792 seconds. Then we click on rise time. You can see that from 1%, which is 0.1, to 90%, which is actually 0.9, the time it took was 0.492 seconds. So it means that the rise time of our system is 0.492 seconds. Then we have steady state. Okay, so you can see on the right side, the steady state of 1 has been achieved. So this was the step response for our overdamped system. And as we discussed earlier, that there are no oscillations and the system has reached its value without any overshoot. Next, the pole zero map. Okay, so the pole zero map shows here the two poles which are having some real values, but there are no imaginary values. You can see that both the poles are on x-axis. They have no value of y, which means no value of imaginary axis over here. And then we can also see that both the poles are having different real values. Okay, so this one is having -18.6 and the other one is having -5.31. So both the values are real, negative, different, and without any imaginary values. So when there are no imaginary values, there is no imaginary part, then there will be no oscillation at all. Okay, and the overshoot is zero as well. Okay, good. Next, we have critically damped systems. So for critically damped system, the zeta must be equal to 1. Again, both poles have real and have same magnitude. You will see in the coming pole zero map then that both the poles will be overlapping each other. And again, they won't be having any imaginary values and the response will be just like this. There will be no oscillation in your system. So critically damped system approach steady state quickest without oscillation. Okay, so both the response, if you see critically damped and the previous one overdamped system have no oscillations, but and also the response looks the same, but the critically damped system will reach its steady state value quicker than that those of a overdamped system. Okay, now we will change the value of damping to 1. Okay, and then we will see the output response. So you can see it's 1, the damping will be 1, and we will save it in G3, and also the axis will be different. The pole zero map, you can just you will be just able to see a single value, single crossover here, but actually these are two poles at same place, so that's why they are overlapping each other, and you will be all it will be like you are seeing only a single value. Okay, and then the step response, you can see that it has reached the final value quicker. If you see the overdamp system, okay, so around here we were achieving the steady state. Okay, it's close to 1, and for this critically damped system, you can see that the steady state has been achieved quicker. It's like it's at 0.6 to 0.8. Okay, Osama puch raha hai, it must necessary for this to have same poles. Yes, it is necessary. Like it is compulsory for a critical damped system, the poles will be always same. If the poles are not same, they don't have an imaginary value, and they are not same, then that system will be overdamped system. It won't be considered as a critically damped system. So for the critically damped system, both the values of both the poles, the real values, will be same. Okay, so we will now simulate this system in MATLAB. So again, I will just change the value of zeta from 1.2, I will change it to 1, and now I will store it in G3, and also I have to change the axis. Okay, so it's, let's run this code. Okay, so again here we see a response. Click on the characteristic. Again, there is no peak at all, means there is no overshoot in the system. Click on the settling time, and the settling time is 0.583. for overdamped system it was 0.7, and for critically damped system it is 0.5, which is quicker. Then the rise time is about 0.336 seconds, and the steady state is achieved at 1. Now we will overview the pole 0. You can see that there is only one visible pole, but the other pole is also here, so these are two poles at minus 10. Damping is 1, there is no overshoot, and the frequency is 10. Okay, so the last time of last type of second order system, the fourth and the last one, is the undamped systems. The undamped systems are having a zeta of 0. It means that there is no damping value, and as there is no damping, so the poles are purely imaginary. Okay, so they will have no value of real, no real value. It means that they will be on 0 at the x-axis, and on y-axis, which is the imaginary axis, they will having some values. System will be marginally stable, but it will oscillate indefinitely. Okay, it will be like this. It will be having a sine wave, you can see it just like a sine wave. So it will have a periodic variation just like a sine wave. So again, code is same. You have to just change your zeta to 0 and then g4 and also change your axis. And you will see that the both the poles will be on 0 of x-axis, which means they have no real parts, and then minus 10 and minus 10 for the imaginary axis. And the waveform, you can see that it will be oscillating it will be a periodic oscillation basically. So now let's execute this code. Okay, so I have to change a few values. You have to change zeta to 0 and अच्छा जी उसामा पूछ रहे हैं इफ़ यू वांट टू टेक प्रीवियस वैल्यू ऑफ एक्सिस समझ नहीं आया मुझे उसामा आप ज़रा माइक पे मुझे बताएं कि कैसे प्रीवियस वैल्यू क्या मतलब जी 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 देखें एक्सिस की वैल्यू तो आप दे सकते हैं कोई भी दे सकते हैं अगर एक्सिस की वैल्यू आप ना भी दें तब भी सिमुलेट हो जाएगा ठीक है सो अगर जो आप कहते हैं कि जो प्रीवियस एक्सिस था वो डाल लेते हैं ओके सो अभी देखें ये जो आपका प्रीवियसली एक्सिस था तो इसको अभी हम डाल देते हैं दिस इज ठीक है इट वाज -20, 1, -1 एंड 1 सो यही वैल्यू हम इसके लिए अभी सिमुलेट कर देते हैं सो यू विल सी के अभी रिस्पांस आ तो जाएगा लेकिन अगेन ये देखें रिस्पांस आ गया सो आ जाएगा ठीक है यू हैव टू जस्ट स्मार्टली डिफाइन दी एक्स एंड दी वाई एक्सिस ठीक है सो इट डजेंट मैटर्स आप जो भी यहाँ पे वैल्यू दोगे ठीक है जो भी आपके एक्सिस की वैल्यू आप दोगे उसी एक्सिस की वैल्यू पे आपका जो जो ग्राफ है वो प्रिंट हो जाएगा ठीक है सो इट शुड बी विद इन द रेंज जो उसकी जहाँ पर वो आ रहा है तो उसकी रेंज के अंदर होना चाहिए दैट्स इट ओके Okay, जी. Okay, so now we have a undamped system. Okay, so for an undamped system, we see that our zeta will be now 0. I will save it now into G4. And the axis again, I'm going to change it, it will be -1, 1 and 15. Axis ki command ke bagair bhi aap isko, you can execute it without the axis command as well. Okay. So it's time to run. So we have our transfer function here. And in a while we will get our graphs. So now you can see that we have constant oscillations. I'll just zoom this graph. Okay. So there's a way. Okay, so now, okay, I have to put it in. Just give me a second. This is the step response we are having. So you can see that we are having constant oscillation, and we normalize this value. Now I'm just going to zoom in. Okay, so now you can see that there are constant variation or periodic signal. It is a like just like a periodic waveform. So it is an undamped system. And if you see the pole zero map, then there are two poles over here. One is at minus 10 imaginary, and the other one is minus 10 imaginary. Okay, so we have two poles over here, and this also shows that there is no damping, and the overshoot is 100% and the frequency is 10. Okay, so you can see that there is an overshoot of 100%. Okay, so this is the overshoot, 100% overshoot. So this was about the types of the system. We have four types. First of all, we had underdamped systems, which had some oscillations, and the poles had the real values as well as imaginary values. Then we have overdamped system, in which the poles only had real values and the system had no oscillations. Then we had critically damped systems, in which both the poles had real values and same values, and there were no imaginary portion of the poles. Then the response also did not have any oscillations, but it was the quickest of all to reach its steady state. And then in the end, we saw the undamped systems, which actually had the value of 0 in the damping. The damping ratio was 0, and the system was periodically oscillating. Both of the poles had only imaginary values without any real values. Now the next portion of the lab is to simulate the second order system using Simulink. So what we have here is a mechanical system, okay, which has a mass, a damper or a dashboard or a spring. So now we will work on this system, second order system, in Simulink. So just imagine that this is a suspension system of a motorbike or a car. So you can just imagine it to be, I will just make it so it is just like a suspension system of some motorbike or some car. So you can see that this can be your motorbike, like this can be attached to the wheel of your motorbike, okay, and the mass is actually if someone is sitting on that motorbike, so that is basically the mass. Okay, this is the seat of your bike basically, and then there is a handle definitely, and there is another tire over there. So okay, and in case of a car, In case of a car, again there will be a tire, okay, which is connected, and this will be just a portion of your tire like this. Okay, there will be also other tires as well. So this is what it looks like for if you see a car or a motorbike. Okay, so now you see that the force will be from above. The people sitting in the car, it will be exerting some force on your mass, basically your damper and spring, and the damper and spring will actually have a opposite force on the mass. Okay, so these are multiple forces which are acting here. So now let us see the characteristic equation. So first of all, we have x double dash, it is the acceleration of the system. Okay, then 1 by m, it is the mass. 1 by m is the mass, and mass is basically it has been exerting a force from top to bottom. And then this is the force f of t. Okay, this is f of t is basically the force which mass is exerting on the dashboard and the spring. C of x dash, C is the dashboard, you can see it is the dashboard, and x dash. Now x dash is the velocity, so it means that C or the dashboard will only spawn when there is a velocity of a system. ठीक है जी, जब इस सिस्टम की कोई वेलोसिटी होगी तभी जो आपका डैशपॉट है दैट विल रिस्पॉन्ड. सिमिलरली वी हैव के ऑफ एक्स. के ऑफ एक्स इज द के इज द स्प्रिंग कॉन्स्टेंट एंड एक्स इज द डिस्प्लेसमेंट. नाउ इफ यू सी अ स्प्रिंग, ओके, सो स्प्रिंग कब एक्शन में आता है कि जब हम इसको डिस्प्लेस करते हैं. नाउ द स्प्रिंग इट रिएक्ट्स when we expand it or we try to compress it. Okay, so actually what we do when we are compressing and when we are expanding a spring, we are displacing, we are producing a displacement in it. Okay, so when we exert force to compress or to elongate or to expand a spring, so it will in return exert a force on the system which will be in the opposite direction. So I hope the equation aapko samajh aa gayi hai, and now we will proceed towards how to make this block diagram in Simulink. Okay, so first of all, what we will do is we will sum all the input signals. Okay, the input signal is basically CX, CX and KX and F of T. These three are input signals. Okay, so these three are your input signals, f of t minus c of x dash and k of x. So here we are summing c of x dash, k of x and f of t. Then we will multiply it by 1 by m. So you can see it is being multiplied by all these three inputs are in multiplication with 1 by m, and which is equal to x double dash. Okay, so we multiply it with 1 by m. Next, I have added two integrators here. One integrator is here and the other integrator is here. Now, as we know that overall this equation is equal to x double dash. It means that double derivative of x. Now, for c, we need x dot, or x dash, we need x dash here, and for k we need x. Okay, so for c we need x dash and for k we need x. So if we apply a integrator to x double dash, then we will get x dash, because if we integrate any signal, then it definitely, if it is a derivative, that it then it will cancel out the derivative. And then if we apply another integrator, okay, so now we will get our x, which is actually the displacement. It is required for k as an input, and also it is the output of our system. The overall system, you can see it here. Okay, so this is the input signal f of t. Here we are summing inputs, all the inputs, which is f of t minus cx dash minus k of x. Then we are going to multiply it with 1 by m, and then the result will be x double dash. We will use an integrator to get x dash, and then another integrator to get x, which is also our output. And then c and k, both of these are constants. Now I will make this in Simulink. I'm just waiting for Simulink to open. Okay, Jalal keh rahe hai repeat. Okay, Jalal, I will make this Simulink diagram, aur saath saath main aapko samjhata rahunga. Okay, so phir in the end jo bhi question ho aap mujhse pooch sakte hain, theek hai? Okay. So Simulink, I have opened the Simulink, and now the library. Aur isi tarah main ye yahan pe niche isko open kar leta hu. Okay, okay, so now, if you look at the diagram, first of all, we need f of t. Okay, so f of t is an input, which is actually the step input, and the inputs, all the inputs, we can find it in sources. So click on sources, and then in sources, you will go and find step. Okay. So just click, right click on the step and add it to your model file. So here's the step. Next we need a subtractor. We need a subtract. So we go to math operations. And here we have a subtract. Again, add this to your model file. Now if you note that in the subtract we got from the library, we have only plus and minus. Okay, we have only two inputs. We can only give it two inputs, and in our diagram we need three inputs. So just double click on it, and you can see a plus sign, a minus sign. Just add another minus. And now you can see you have three inputs. Okay, you can now give it three inputs. So the positive input will be connected to the step just like in the diagram. And you can name this step as f of t as well. Just click on step and then you can rename it as f of t. Next we need some gains. Again, gain you can find it in math. The math operation has gain. So we need three gains. So just add three gains. This is number one. And the first gain is actually 1 by m. Then we add another gain, which is actually c. And then another gain, which is actually K. So just double click on the gain and then you will be able to assign the values of C, K and M. Okay, secondly we have to flip the values now. We have to flip the values of these gains, because you can see that in the diagram they have been flipped also. So just right click and then in the format go to right click, go to format, go to rotate and flip and click on flip block. Similarly, you can also do it by just pressing Ctrl and I. Click on the MATLAB, the gain block, and press Ctrl and I from your keyboard, and you can flip the blocks. Okay. So, these will be connected here. For C and for K, just like we have done in the diagram. M. Now we need two integrators as well. So click on continuous in the library, and in the continuous library, Simulink continuous library, you will find the integrator. Now add two integrators. Here's the first one. And then the second one. So we have got two integrators over here. And the values for C we need x dash, and then we need a scope from the sinks. You can go to sinks and then add a scope to view the output. So here's your complete system, just like the one made there. Okay, so this is your complete system. I hope this is visible. Okay. So now we have to assign multiple values. I'm just going to explain this system once again for Jalal, as he requested to explain the equation. Okay, so Jalal, and this was our equation over here, and we have modeled this equation using, I'm just going to copy paste it there in the Simulink, so I hope you can see it. Okay, so this is our equation. First of all, we have three inputs, f of t. Okay, this is f of t, which you can see here, which is the step basically. Then, okay, this is the step, this is the f of t. Then secondly, we have cx dash, okay, cx dash, and this is also minus cx dash. So what I have done here, I have made this block, gain block c, and x is multiplied with it as an input. It is coming as an input, it is multiplied. And then we had k, okay, for k of x, I have this block, and k is, I'm having x as an input, and it has been multiplied with k. And then if you see the subtractor block, if you can see this block, then f of t is plus and c and k are minus. So this block here gives us x of double dash, means acceleration. X double dash means acceleration. Next, what do we need here? We need, okay, someone else has joined. Okay, so next what we need here is x dash. Okay, so I have inserted a integrator over here, and this integrator will actually convert this x double dash or double derivative of x to x dash. Okay, so when the value, the signal will be passed from the first integrator, the output will be x dash, which is the single derivative. Okay, then this x dash is actually required for c. Okay, so when there is any velocity of the system, then only will c operate. Okay, so c will only operate when there is a velocity of a signal, a velocity in the system. Then another integrator, we placed another integrator so that we can integrate x dash and get x as an output. So we got x as our output, and this x is also required by the spring constant or the k. So when we feed this x into k, so k will be in action, when k will only respond when there is a displacement in the system. So this was about the Simulink diagram. Okay, जी माजिद ने कॉल की है तो आई होप इनको कोई बता दे. क्लास इज ऑन हैंग आउट, लिंक इज सब गिवन ऑफ. ओके, सो नाउ वी हैव गॉट ओवर सिमुलिंग डायग्राम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल कॉन्फिगर the f of t. So f of t will be having a step time of 1, which means that up to one up to 1 second, the value the graph will be or the input will be zero, which is the initial value, and then the final value is one. So after 1 second, the output will be then the input of the system will be one. Okay. Then we need to define the value of M, C, and K. So if you look at the slides, I have defined the value of M, C, and K. So M is equal to 2, and C is equal to 2, and K is equal to 4. Okay, I'm just waiting that slides show up. Okay, Jalal, so ab aapko clear ho gaya hai about the equation. Okay, so Jalal is saying yes sir. Okay, so I'm just waiting ke ye slides aa jaye aapke screen ke upar. Okay, presentation. Okay, I think slides nazar nahi aa rahi, so we'll wait a bit. Slides aa jaye. अच्छा जी, तो स्लाइड्स नजर आ रही हैं आप लोगों को? अच्छा अच्छा ओके ओके, मैं दोबारा से इसको ऑन कर देता हूँ. Okay, now we are back on. Okay. So now you can see here that we simulated our system. And we have made the diagram of our system, and now we have to input the values. So the values over here, for M we have 2, for C we have 2, and for K we have 4. So you can just enter these values simply in these boxes of Simulink. Okay, that's the gain you have made in the Simulink. So you can just enter these values here, like 1 by m is 2, so 1 by 2 it will become 1 by 2, and similarly for, just waiting ke aapko ye nazar aa jaye. Okay. Achha ji. So just double click on the block and you can change the values. Okay, so now you can see that 1 by 2, okay, you can just click on the blocks and change the values, like you can add 1 by 2 or just keep it the same way, 1 by M, 1 by C, 1 by M, C and K. Achha, again, mere khayal se video again chali gayi hai, so I will rejoin. जी जदाद आपको मुझे आपका लास्ट वीक का टास्क रिसीव हो गया. ओके ओके सो दिस इज आवर फाइनल डायग्राम एंड नाउ वी हैव टू असाइन वैल्यूज एंड आई टोल्ड यू कि आप नाउ यू कैन जस्ट डबल क्लिक ऑन एनी ऑफ द गेन ब्लॉक and you can assign the values like 1 by 2 or 2 or 4, anything you want to do. Okay, you can just edit the values here, or if you want to keep it this way like 1 by M or C and K, you can simply go to your command window, and in the command window you can define the values like M is equal to 2, C is equal to 2 and K is equal to 4. So these values will be given to you. These are the constant of mass, spring and damper, and these values you can enter them here, and you can also enter them in your Simulink blocks. Next we have to start simulation. Okay, so you have to just run this simulation by the play icon, okay, or at the top, just click on that and you can run this simulation, and then you can double click on the scope to see the output of your system. Now you can see that we have got a waveform, and as I told you that the waveform will start from 1 up to we have given a step time of 1 and initial value of 0, so it will start from 1 and then it will oscillate. Definitely it's a underdamped second order system, so as we can see from the graph, so it will oscillate and then it will be reach its steady state, but we cannot see the steady state of our system here. So what it means that we have to run our system for a longer period of time. So what you can do here, you can see a time box. Okay, so you can see a value of time at the top of your simulation Simulink. So you can just increase that. You can increase. I will increase it up to 25 seconds. So now the simulation will run up to 25 seconds. So once you are going to run it, then now you see your output is basically is executed for a longer period of time, and you can see that the steady state is achieved somewhere around 12 or 13. Okay, so this was all about today's lecture, and main abhi aapko इसका लैब टास्क भी दिखा देता हूँ. Okay, so this is lab task number 5, which I will upload on your Google Classroom. So first of all, 5.1, there is a question in which you have to simulate a system for with these values. KGC is 1, natural frequency is 10, and zeta is 0.2. So you will simply have to run the code, the same code we used, and enter these values. If you have ID3 written over here, so ID3 means that if your ID is 311 or your ID is 324, then you will enter the fourth digit of your ID over here. So it will be, your KGC will be 4. Okay, and then you have to generate the PZ map with response for pole zeros, plot for pole zeros. You have to generate the step response, and you also have to define that what kind of system it is. So you can simply see the zeta and the graph as well, and you can mention which value, which kind of system is it. Okay, second one is same, just 5.2 is same as just like 5.1, but the zeta is changed here. Then 5.3, again the zeta is changed, and for 5.4, then you need to make a body plot. In 5.5 you need to make a body plot for 5.1 5.2 5.3 and 5.4. now body plot, I will add a slide in your the slides, but okay, so it just it's a lab task, so I will not go much, I will not elaborate it much. You need to search for the body plot. So simply you will have to make a body plot of all the four systems, like 5.1 5.2 5.3. say 5.1 in G1, then 5.2 in G2, 5.3 in G3 and in G4, and simply apply the body function on all of these transfer functions, and then you will get a response over here. I will add this slide as well. Okay, and then in 5.6 we have a system in which we have a mechanical system with mass, spring and damper, and you just have to simulate this system in Simulink. And then 5.7, we have a electrical system. We have RLC instead of MC and K. So what you have to do, you have to replace the values of M, C and K with RLC. You just have to figure out that what value basically in your Simulink diagram, like M will be replaced by what? M will be replaced by R or by L or by C. So you will have to figure it out that what values for MCK, what is M equivalent to the electrical system? Okay, is it R, is it L, or is it C? And similarly, what is the K equivalent in the electrical system? What is the C equivalent in the electrical system? So you have to find those equivalent, and then just simply put the values on this in this Simulink diagram. Okay. Okay, so this was all. Now we can take any questions. जो भी आपके questions हों तो आप यहाँ पे mic on करके भी पूछ सकते हैं, and आप जो है message करके भी मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं.